Hi everybody, thank you for watching. So today's video is going to be my Sigma Beauty and makeup collection. So I launched a new series last month where every month I'm going to pick a brand and walk you through my makeup collection with everything from that brand. So I started it last month with Pure Cosmetics, so I'll leave that video linked down below in case you're interested in checking it out. And this month I am featuring Sigma Beauty. I'm really excited to feature Sigma because they are definitely one of my favorite brands. I started purchasing from them before I had my YouTube channel. They were my first like higher end brush purchase and I was so excited for it, and I can actually remember the first package that I ordered. I continued to keep purchasing from Sigma. I'm actually very lucky to now be a Sigma affiliate. Sigma was the very first brand that I became an affiliate with. I remember the day that they accepted me into their affiliate program, and it was just so crazy because it was, you know, this was one of the first bigger brands that I ever purchased from. This was the first high-end makeup brushes that I ever used, and you know, now they were interested in having me join the family. So I just thought that was really neat. So I will have everything that I talk about linked in the description box below, and those are affiliate links. You know, a huge thank you to Sigma for having me in their family. I appreciate it so much. I don't have a code with Sigma like Samantha or whatever. I just have the links right now, but maybe one day I'll have my own code that you guys can use as well. But I'm excited to show you everything. The majority of what I have from Sigma is brushes. I love Sigma brushes. I recommend them all the time. I'm gonna go over what I have from them makeup wise first, and then I'll move into my brushes last because it's a lot of brushes, so hold on to your hats. I'm really excited to share with you my Sigma Beauty makeup collection, and if you'd like to see everything that I have from Sigma Beauty, please keep watching. So one of my hands down favorite items from Sigma, I recommend this all the time as well. This is their gel liner in Wicked, which is black. I have it on my eyes right now. It's the first gel liner that I feel like I really fell in love with. I don't know if you'd be able to see in there, but it's not looking great. It's almost gone because I use it so often. Like I said, this was the first gel liner that I really fell in love with, and this was the one that I was like, oh, this is why people like gel liner. Like, it just glides on super easily, super smoothly. I do have a brush that I'll recommend as well that I definitely say to use with this liner, but it's an excellent liner. It's very black, very easy to use, very easy to work with, glides on super easily. I love it so much. The Wicked gel liner is a big fave of mine. These two makeup products I actually featured a while back in like my most underrated makeup video. I did one a handful of months back and I featured both of these from Sigma, and I am wearing both of them on my face right now as well. The first one is their blush, and this is in Cor de Rosa, and it says it's an aura powder, and which is a blush. This is what the blush looks like. It does have a mirror as well, and it is what I have on my cheeks for my blush. It's a very beautiful blush, kind of like that terracotta type of color, and it is so pigmented. Like, I remember the first time using it, and I, you know, looking at it, I'm like, oh, okay, it looks like a nice blush, and I really went in there with my brush and then put it on, and I was like, whoopsies. You need a very, very tiny amount with this blush because it is so pigmented, and it's also super long lasting. I don't feel like enough people talk about this blush, and it's gorgeous. Again, mine is in Cor de Rosa, and I think it is fabulous. This is the lip color that I'm wearing right now. I also featured it in my underrated makeup video. This is the Power Stick lipstick in Spades. So this is what the packaging looks like, and it's very like heavy. Like, this is like a boss lipstick. And then when you open it up, you have the shade right here. So again, it's what I have on my lips, but I really like these lipsticks. I feel like more people should be talking about them. Okay, I have a couple of like makeup tools to go over. Makeup essentials, maybe you could say. But the first thing that I want to talk about in this category is a brand new product from Sigma. I believe at the time that my video goes up, this will not even be yet for sale, but you can fill out the waiting list on the Sigma Beauty website. It is their new 3D HD blender. I used this today, so you cannot be mad at me. I only have a limited number of hours to film with natural sunlight, so I didn't have time to be cleaning everything. My brushes are gonna be dirty as well because I use them all on my face. But these are the new 3D HD blenders from Sigma Beauty, and oh, Sigma sent me these early so I could try them out and review them and let you guys know what I think about them. And I'm so glad that they did, because I am like, I love these blenders. I'm a big fan of makeup sponges and beauty sponges. I've tried the beauty blenders. I have ones from Real Techniques. I have the diamond sponge. I've definitely tried a lot of the different blenders, and I was really excited for this one because it has such this like unique shape. It has all these different angles. It has points. I mean, even when you flip it this way, you got more designs going on, and I was just excited to try it out. I will leave some videos linked down below to my Instagram where you can see me doing a tutorial and using these. It's like the possibilities are endless. When you get this thing wet, it gets very, very large. That was the first thing I noticed once I ran it underwater. I was like, whoa, that is a big makeup sponge. And then because you have all of these different sides to it, you can actually do a full face of makeup with just your makeup sponge. And that's really hard to do. You can do everything with this sponge. This is one that I highly recommend. It's going to launch February 27th, and it's going to be $15, which I think is also a good price. The original beauty blenders are $20, and you are spending $15, and you're getting something that can do your entire face of makeup, foundation, concealer, cream, bronzer. You can do these little, like this side, this little edge right here is like my favorite for cream contouring, and you can even do them down the sides of your nose. You can apply your highlight to your face. You can get right in between your eyebrows, you can get around your lips, around your nose. Like, I mean, the possibilities are just endless with this thing, and I think it is such a good product. The only thing I would say about it is that I think it's a little bit firmer than I prefer it to be, because I like really bouncy makeup sponges. It's not the bounciest I've ever used, but that's literally my only con to this thing. Otherwise, I think it's fantastic. I think a lot of people will really like these, and I'm excited for them to launch. I've just been beating up this black one. This is what I've been going to every single day as I've been testing it out. I wanted to leave one nice and pretty for this video so you can see what it looks like when you're not using it every single day. But this is the 3D HD Blender from Sigma Beauty. Launches February 27th. I highly recommend it, guys. Next up, I'm super excited to talk about these two products because I feel like these are essentials. So the first one that I have is the Sigma Spa Glove. So this is a tool to clean your makeup brushes. Cleaning makeup brushes are so important. I know so many people that don't see the importance of cleaning your makeup brushes, but it's so important because then you're putting those brushes on your face and you're just spreading bacteria and germs and putting all that ickiness back on your face if you're not washing your brushes. And I think having tools really helped step up my personal brush cleaning game, because otherwise I was always just using the palm of my hand and it just gets gross and it doesn't make your hand feel the greatest. It's not very fun. So when I got the Sigma Spa Glove, this was just like an immediate game changer. It's really cool because it has these different like ridges and grooves on there so you can clean all of your brushes. It has like a little slip here. If you want to keep it on your hand, you sure can. A lot of times, it kind of depends, I guess, on how many brushes I'm cleaning. Sometimes I keep it on my hand, but sometimes I just lay it flat in my sink and do it that way. They have other options of these available as well. They have bigger ones that basically covers your full sink, but I think these are great. Everyone needs a tool like this, I think. I think these are really handy. And then the other item I have to go along with that is a makeup brush cleaner. This is the Sig Magic Shampoo, and this was like total game changer for me. I feel like this was a pretty hyped up product, but I feel like it was for a good reason, is because it's just awesome. So it's a makeup brush cleaner. It is 100% natural. That was kind of like the big thing around this. This was all natural, and I think that's really important as well when you think about cleaning your makeup brushes, because you want to clean it with good products, because again, you're then putting it back on your face. But I use this all of the time for cleaning my brushes. It's super easy. You use a few pumps. I will say that it says on here, right, it says pump 1 to 3 times directly into damp brush fibers. I think that you need more than that. Like in my personal experience, I think you need like 6 or 7. And of course, depending on the size of your brush, but like for a good size, like foundation brush, I think you need like 7 pumps of the product to make sure that you're really getting all of it clean. But it's just so handy. It's super easy to use. It has a pump, so very easy. I have less than half left and I'm so sad, but I would definitely repurchase this because I just find it so essential in my brush cleaning game. So last up, I have my makeup brushes, and I have a lot of brushes from Sigma Beauty. I love their brushes. I think they're bomb. I recommend their brushes to everybody. And if you can't tell, I love the Sigma Beauty brushes. This is definitely what I have the most of out of my collection, so that's why I wanted to leave it for last. I'll run through each brush and kind of the use for them, and I can let you guys know what are my absolute favorites, what I use on like a very regular basis, but let's go ahead and jump into my brushes. I'm not gonna go in any particular order. I'm just going to go ahead and set these on my lap and run through them. So the first one that I'm grabbing out is the Sigma F89. This is the Bake Kabuki brush. So it has this curved edge here, Kabuki brush. What I use this for is to bake, to put like the setting powder to like clean up my contour. I think it's really good for that. I don't love it for under the eyes because it's a little bit bigger, but for the sides of the face, I think it works great. This little guy, I absolutely love. I would totally recommend this. This is one that I didn't think I would love or even reach for a lot, and I totally do. This is the strobing fan, the F42. So it's just a little fan brush, but it's like, it's dense. It's not like a really flimsy fan brush because I've had those a lot. And when you actually try to apply your highlight, it just doesn't really go anywhere or do anything. But because this one is more dense, when you apply your highlight, it actually shows up and it works really well. So the F42, I would also recommend. This is the Cut Crease E62 brush. So this is what this one looks like, and this is what I use to apply the concealer on my eyes when I am doing a cut crease. It's really nice because it has more of like an angled tip, so I can really make sure I'm like sharply cutting the crease with it. I mean, this brush is made for cut creases, and it really has helped me out. I've never had a brush like this in my collection, and when I was practicing cut creases in the past, it was really hard to be able to define a cut crease with the concealer, and I think since having this brush, it really has helped me out. This brush is one of my favorites. I think I've put this in a favorites video. This is the F06 Powder Sweep. And so when I got this brush, I was like, okay, so you use it to like sweep away powder. Like, I don't know, that just seems a little almost like bougie. Like, do you need a separate brush like just for that reason? Like, my other brushes work just fine. It definitely does good for that. You can sweep away your powder, sweep away the powder. It's also a really good highlighting brush. I will say that it's a good highlighting brush because it's almost like a little bit on the denser side, but it's still like fluffy up top. I don't know how this brush works, but it can do a lot of different things. But highlighting is definitely one thing that it does very well. But what I love this for and use on nearly a daily basis is for powder contour. I have the Physician's Formula. They just came out with like a trio of contour powders, and I am obsessed with using one of those powders with this brush. It has like changed my contour game, I swear to you. Like, I've just been loving it so much. It is perfect to get right in there and create the contour. This is what I love this brush for. But like I said, it has other uses as well. This is just a huge favorite of mine. Then to keep it rolling, I have the Bent Liner Brush. This is the B12. I was super intrigued to try this out because I had never tried a bent liner brush, and I actually like it more than I thought I was maybe going to. I was a little scared of like, how is this gonna work logistically? But I actually like it. Like I said, I like it more than I thought I was going to, and I also like the actual brush of it because it's so like thin and small, and that's what I really like in my liner brushes. But then it's really cool just to be able to, whatever type of wing it is that you want, the different ways that you hold it can just really help you out and make it easier. I was surprised. I was surprised at this one, and I wasn't sure it was something like, do I need it? Will I really love it? This isn't my favorite winged liner brush from Sigma. That one is still coming up, but this is still a really good one. So this one is the Buff and Blend, the E39 brush. And this was one that I was like, okay, like I'll probably think it's fine, but I don't know. It's kind of a thicker, denser brush. And when I first tried it, I immediately fell in love with it, and I reached for this one a lot. You can pack the product on there. Then also it's kind of fluffy at the same time, so you can actually blend your shadows together. So it's kind of like a two-in-one brush, and I really like it. I reach for this a lot, and this is also a brush that I travel with a lot because I feel like it has the multiple functions. That's what I look for when I'm grabbing my travel brushes. So this one comes with me a lot. So this guy is the 3D HD Kabuki brush. So here is what this one looks like. Kind of fun. Has the 3D effect to it. Now, I'm not gonna lie when I say that I'm not exactly positive why I enjoy this brush so much, because I don't know if I quite fully grasp the concept of what the 3D part of it is doing. I just know that it works really well and I really enjoy it. A lot of times what I do is I'll put the foundation right on here, and then I'll take these like sides and I'll like smooth the foundation out, and then I will turn it so it's like this, and then I will buff it out. I also like the curve that it has because I feel like it's easy to fit the brush like around my nose and it angles like this. I mean, I don't know if this like helped inspire the 3D HD blender. I'm not sure, but I like the similar concepts. I just feel like I feel like it has more than a regular foundation brush, you know what I'm saying? And I really appreciate that. So the 3D HD Kabuki was another one that I unexpectedly really enjoyed. Another one that I'm pretty sure I've mentioned in a favorites video, this is the F79, the Concealer Blend Kabuki. So what I use this for is to buff out my under eye concealer. I have actually also used it to blend out cream contour. There's been times when I was traveling and I forgot my tool for that. So I use this and it works out just fine. But the main reason that I use this for is for under eye concealer, and I think it's freaking bomb. Bomb. I love this brush for that. I like that it's smaller, yet it's still big enough that you can actually blend everything out quickly and easily, but it's small enough to really get up in there under your lashes. It's small enough to get into the inner parts of your eyes. I just love it. I can't remember what month it was that I put it in a favorites video, but I love this brush. I travel with it and I use it almost every single day. One is the Medium Sweeper E54, one of my favorite brushes, one that I travel with very often because I just feel like this is essential. I used it today to pack on the gold shade on the inner part of my eyes. For me, this is like my shimmer shade brush. I knew that was going to be tough to say. So anytime I'm applying like a shimmery type of eyeshadow, this is the brush I'm reaching for. If I'm using like a loose pigment, I'll spray my brush with like some Fix Plus and then I'll apply it. This goes with me as well in my travel bag. This one is the P89. This is the Bake Precision brush. This is like the other, like there was a bigger brush of this guy and now this one is the smaller one. I like to use the bigger one for along my face to like clean up contour. This is what I like to use under my eyes, and I like it because you can get right up in there, and then it also has the angle to it as well, which I think is really helpful. So I use this brush quite a bit. So this was in my very first package that I ordered from Sigma. I knew that I needed to work on my winged eyeliner, so I purchased an eyeliner brush. This is the Small Angle E65 brush. So this is what it looks like. And it's funny because when I got this and I was practicing my winged liner, I really, really enjoyed this brush and I thought it worked great. Since then, I've actually fallen in love with a different brush. If you guys have been subscribers of my channel, you already know what brush I'm talking about, but if you're new here, you're probably like, what brush are you talking about? Just get on with it. What brush do you use? But I found after going to a smaller brush that this one was just too big. So I don't use this one as much anymore, but this is like my OG, my first winged liner brush. So the winged liner brush that I absolutely swear by, I use it today, I use it so often, I recommend it all the time. This is the E06 winged liner brush. And I feel like a lot of people talk about this brush, but for a very good reason, and it's because it's bomb. It's dirty because I just used it to apply my winged liner. It is so small and so teeny tiny and so precise, yet it makes the best wing. Like, I feel like with this brush, it's hard to screw up and it's hard to make mistakes because it's so small that you can really build your wing. And for me, and for someone who I'm still learning how to do my wings, I'm still finding the best way for me to do them. For me to be able to build them up and do the smaller strokes just works easier for me than having a big brush and just coming right in and trying to make wings and then getting messy. So this small brush works out so much better. The E06 I think is amazing. You pair this with the Wicked Gel Liner, it's just like a match made in eyeliner heaven. It's amazing. And then these last two brushes I feel like are just so special to me because, again, these are the brushes that I made in my very first Sigma purchase. So the one was the bigger wing liner brush, and then I have these two brushes as well. And it's so funny because when I was, you know, before I had my YouTube channel, but when I was starting to get more into makeup and I was watching the beauty videos, it's funny what I took away from it because I took away that you needed to have a fierce wing. So that's why I got the wing liner brush. But I also took away that you needed a fantastic foundation brush. And I also took away that you had to have a blending brush. Like, you needed those things in your collection. So the blending brush that I had chose was one I saw a lot of people recommend, and it is the E25 blending brush, and I love this brush. I love this brush so much. I wish I had like 40 of these brushes because I think they are fantastic. I definitely used it today to apply my crease shade, and I think it is so good. I feel like everybody needs the E25. I know this is a very like talked about and, you know, kind of hyped up brush, but for a very good reason. So I love this little brush so much, the E25. I always recommend this as well. And then the last brush that I have to share in the final product for this video is the F80 Kabuki brush. Everybody was talking about the F80. Everybody was talking about it. Everybody was recommending it. And it's one of my favorite brushes. This was like my first real foundation brush, my first high-end foundation brush, but it was also my only foundation brush for a very like long period of time. This was the only brush I had, and I worked this brush. I've also had it for many years now. Like, I should probably replace it just to like give this one a break, like let this one go into retirement, because it got used and it got used hard. But again, one of my favorite brushes. A lot of people talk about this one still to this day and still really like it, and I would definitely agree. I would always recommend the F80 Kabuki. Alright guys, that is going to be everything for my Sigma Beauty and Makeup Collection. I hope that you guys enjoyed seeing this video and seeing everything that I have from Sigma Beauty. I'm really excited to make these makeup collection videos. I just think it's kind of like fun and interesting to see what we have from different brands. Let me know in the comments down below what you would like to see for next month's makeup brand that I will feature and walk you through my collection. Like I said, everything that I talked about will be linked in the description box down below. All the names of everything, I'll have them in the description box down below. I had a great time sharing with you my Sigma collection. Like I said, I love Sigma, one of my favorite brands, ones that I continue to repurchase from over and over, that I started buying from before I had my YouTube channel, and I just really love Sigma as a brand. So that is going to wrap it up for this video. I hope that you guys did enjoy it. If you did, make sure to give me a thumbs up. I hope that you will subscribe before you go, and I'll catch you real soon in my next one. Bye!